Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. So today we're going to discuss about list comprehension and the list built-in functions or methods. So what is this list comprehension? So we know what is iteration. So iteration inside a list. So if you see iterating on list, so for where in iterable, like, so if you say for x in some list name, that means, for example, if you have 10 elements inside a list, so it will iterate through the, all the 10 elements. Okay. So like that, so list comprehension is also same. So for item in iterable, okay. So what is iteration for where in iterable? So what is list comprehension for item in iterable with an expression? Okay. So if you say, if you have X, so if you want to perform power of X, so I can give in the place of expression. Okay. For item in iterable. So here I'll give some condition. Okay, so this expression can be any expression, is evaluated once for each item. An iterable object can be a list, a tuple, or whatever it is. Okay, so if you see here, if you see an example here, x to the power of 2, okay, for x in range of 5. Okay, so what does it print? Okay, so x to the power of 2 for x in range 5. So for x in range 5. So what is range 5? Your start is 0. Your stop is 4. Okay. So 5 is excluded. It will include up to 4. So 0 to 4. Okay. So first initially x is 0. So 0 to the power of 2. 0. Next x is 1. 1 to the power of 2. 1. Next x is 2. 2 to the power of 2. 4. 3 to the power of 2. 9. 4 to the power of 2. 16. Okay, so we'll end with 4. Why? Because we have taken range up to 5. 5 is excluded. We should include up to 4. So 0 to 4. So in this way, we can include expression as well as the condition, like for loop in the same. Okay. Okay, so if you see, print x to the power of 2 for x in range of 5. So you can see the output 0, 1 to the power of 2, 1, 2 to the power of 2, 4, 3 to the power of 2, 9, and 4 to the power of 2, 16. Okay, so this is called list comprehension. Okay, so we have an expression as well as at the same time we are checking the iteration condition. Okay, so you can see different examples here. So my list equal to an empty list. For I in range 0 comma 5, my list dot append. So in this way, we can do this. Or square list equal to empty, empty list for I in range of 0 comma 5. If I percentile 2, so here I percentile 2 double equal to 0 in the sense, we are appending only the even. Okay. And next is my list equal to I for I in range of 0 comma 5. So in this way, we can also write, or else we can write like this also, list comprehension. So I into I. For I in range 0 comma 5, if I percentile 2 equal to 0. So we should take only even. Okay, in the range of 0 to 4. 0, 1, 2, 3. So out of that, we take even. So what are even here? 0, 2, 4. So 0 into 0, 0. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 4, 16. So what output we got here? 0 comma 4 comma 16. Okay. And here comes our most important concept, list built-in functions or methods. So total we have 13 built-in functions or methods inside a list. The first one is append, second one is extend, insert, remove, pop, slice, reverse, length of, minimum and maximum, count, index, sort, clear. Okay, so we'll discuss each one. Okay, the first one is append with an example. Okay, so I'm not showing it in execution. Why? Because I have included here. Okay, so the append method is used to add elements at the end of the list. Okay, so we already checked this example using append. So this method can only add a single element at a time. Okay, so if you see my list equal to this one, so my list dot append of 4. Okay, so where it will append? After makes learning fun. anyways, I'll show it. Okay, so my underscore list dot append of. So if you want to append some tag, so see where it will be appended. So let me print. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it is appended after 5. Okay, so 10. So for example, if you want to append one more thing, like 11. So where it will be appended? So it will be appended after 10. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 11. Okay. Now if you want to append many elements, okay, inside a loop. So it's better to use inside a loop like range. So for I in range 7, 9. Okay. For I in range 7, 9. Okay. So print I. So 7, 8. Okay, and that too my list dot append. Sorry, first we should give my list my underscore list dot append of I. So if I execute this, and I should print my underscore list. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 11, and 7 and 8 are included. Why 7 and 8 are included? So my start is 7, my stop is 9. So obviously we'll exclude 9, we'll take up to 8. So 7 comma 8 is included. So in this way, we can include many elements using loops with range. Okay. So this is the first method, append. So next is extend. Okay. So the extend method is used to add, add more than one element at the end of the list. Although it can add more than one element unlike append, it adds them at the end of the list like append. So my list dot extend of 4, 5, 6. Okay, so at a single stretch, it can append multiple elements. Okay. So if I say my underscore list dot append of, so I want to append 20, 30, 40 on a single stretch. Okay. So let me print my underscore list. So I can see 20, 30, 40 is appended. Okay. Right. So here also I can do like this for I in range 7, 9. So my list got append of I, print my list. So in this way, I can use extend. Okay. Oh, I have used append. Sorry, we should use extend. Okay. So if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 11, 20, 30, 40. So 20, 30, 40 is added. Okay. So this is called extend. So here we can use multiple elements at a time. So this is the second method. Third one, insert. So we can insert an element at the given position in the list. So we can insert an element at the given position in the list. Thus, unlike append, it can add elements at any position. But like append, it can add only one element at a time. Okay. So the syntax is like, here we have two. Okay. Here it takes two arguments. The first argument specifies the position. So where it should where it should insert, like position, like index. And the second argument is nothing but your element to be inserted. So don't get confused. This is not element. This is index or the position. The second one is element. Okay, for example, if I have my underscore list equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So next, what we need to do? My underscore list dot insert of. Okay, so for example, if I want to insert the 0, 1 second position, so the first argument is the position, comma, I want to insert element 10. Okay, so my underscore list dot insert of in the second position, I want to insert element 10. Okay, so let me print this. Okay, so 1, 2 in the second position, I inserted 10. Okay, if you see extend or append, so what happens? It adds to the end of the list. But here we can add at any position which we need. But it takes two arguments. This insert method takes two arguments. The first one is your position where you want to insert. The second one is the element which you want to insert at that particular position. Okay. My list dot insert 4, 5. The first one is your position. Second one is your element. Okay. So this is the insert method. So next is remove. So what is remove here? The remove method is used to remove an element from the list. In the case of multiple occurrences of the same element, only the first occurrence is removed. Okay. So if you say my list dot remove of that particular element. Okay. For example, if I give multiple occurrences here. So my underscore list dot remove, and I want to remove, and here I'm giving the element to be removed. Don't get confused. It's not the position I'm giving. It's not the index I'm giving. I want to remove element 3 here. So I will provide 3. Okay. So let's see. Let's print this. My underscore list. So if I execute this, I got 1, 2, 4, 5. So what happened here? The element 3 is removed. So let me have some repetitions like 3, 3, 3, 3. Okay. See how many how many times 3 repeated? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But if we remove only the first occurrence, so when is 3 first occurred? So that 3 will be removed. Okay. So if you say my list dot remove of 3, so this 3 will be removed, which is at position 2, and the remaining 3s will be present. So if you execute this, you can see 1, 2, that 3 is removed, and the remaining 3s are present. 4, 5, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Okay, so this is one important point to be noted. So the only first occurrence is removed. So if there are any repetitions, so if there are no repetitions, then there is no problem for us. Next, pop method. So the method pop can remove an element from any position in the list. This, the parameter supplied to this method is the index of the element to be removed. Okay. So if I say my list dot pop of 4. Okay. So it removes which is there in that position. Okay. So if I say my list dot pop of 3. So what is present in the index 3 here? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So if you print this, 1, 2, 3, 4 is removed. Okay. So which is that index 0, 1, 2, 3, third index. Third index is we have an element 4, that 4 is removed. You can see the output here. Okay. So we can also insert at that particular position using insert. So what is pop method used for? Pop method can remove an element from any position in the list. The parameter supplied to this method is the index of the element to be removed. So next is slice. The slice operation is used to print a section of the list. The slice operation returns a specific range of elements. Okay. So as we said that we have a start, stop, and step. Okay. So for example, okay. So my list dot slice of. Okay, so if I say only column, so all elements will be present. You can see. So list object has no attribute. No, I want to print. So we don't have an object output called slice. So what simply I'm doing is, so print my underscore list of, here if I give only column, so all the elements will be printed. Okay, so 1, 2, 4, 5. So if I specify the first is 0, that is start, and if I specify up to 4, so what happens here, the start is 0 and stop is 4, 4 will be excluded, it will include up to 3, so 0, 1, 2, 3. So what do we have in 0th index? 1, first index 2, second index 3, and third index 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is printed. So if you see, 1, 2, 3, 4 is printed. So if I want to say my start is 2, and if I want to say 6, okay, so my start is 2 and my stop is 6. So it will start from second index and it will print up to fifth index. Why? Because 6 is excluded. Okay, so 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is present in 2, 3, 4, 5? 3, 4, 5, 3. Okay, so if I execute, you'll get 3, 4, 5, 3. So this is what slicing is. Okay, so if you not provide anything, everything will be printed. So for example, there is no rule that we should print stop. So if I say 2 colon, that's it. So starting from 0, 1, second index, it will print the remaining. So you can see 3, 4, 5, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Okay. So starting from second index, it will print the remaining elements present in the list. And next is reverse. Okay. So the reverse operation used to reverse the elements of the list. This method modifies the original list. To reverse a list without modifying the original one, we use the slice operation with the negative indices. Okay, so here my list of colon colon minus 1 does not modify the original list. So if we use my list dot reverse method, it modifies the original list. So my underscore list dot reverse method and print my underscore list. So if you see, it is, the list is reversed, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. So, does not modify the original list. Okay. Whereas reverse modifies the original list. Okay. Next is length. So length is, gives the, how many elements present in the list. Okay. So let me remove this. Length of my underscore list. So if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total we have 10 elements. So the length is 10. Okay. So how many elements do we have here? 10 elements. So this is the length method. So minimum and maximum. So if I say min of my underscore list. So we got 1. So in the given list, 1 is minimum. So if I say max of my underscore list, if I say 5 is maximum, so I got 5. Okay, so next is count. Okay, so count is how many times the element occurs. So if I say my underscore list dot count of, see, if I say 3, see, in our list, how many times 3 is occurred? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if I say 3 is 3, it gives the count of the element 3 which is occurred in the list. How many times does it occur? So you can see 6 times it occurred in the list. The count is 6 for the element 3 which is repeated inside the list. Okay. So if I say 1, count of 1. So it is repeated only once. So I'll get 1. So if you say 2, so remember it's not index, it's the element, it checks for how many times it is it occurred in the list. So if I say 2, 2 also occurred only one time, but whereas 3 occurred 6 times. Okay, so next is index. Okay, so the index method returns the position of the first occurrence of the given element. It takes two optional parameters, the begin index and the end index. These parameters define the start and end positions of the start area of the list. Okay. My list equal to searches in the whole list. So in dot index of edu cba, if you say that, so it searches the whole list. Okay, so if you give the positions, okay, so for example, if I say Okay, so where is two located? It searches in the list. It is present in the first index. So if I say three, so it is present in the second index. So whereas the three is also present in the remaining indices, but it returns the first occurrence of the position where three is present. Okay, so we can also give from second zero to second position. Okay, so if we say dot index 3 comma, I want to search from 0 to 0 comma 9. Okay, so second position. Okay, so it always returns the element inside a list. So first where it is occurred, and it searches in the whole list and checks if you have any repetitions. It searches for the list which is the element which is occurred for the first time. Okay. And next is sort method. So this method, the sort method, sorts the list in the ascending order. Okay. So for example, if you have a 4 2 6 5 0 1 dot sort, so you will get 0 1 2 4 5 6. So clear. So clear function erases all the elements from the list and empties it. So dot sort of, so if I execute this, none. Okay. Okay, so my underscore list, so we should not give that in print. My underscore list dot sort of. Okay, so make sure of your spelling mistake, sort, and print my underscore list. So if I execute 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now it is in order. Okay, and next is if I give clear. Okay, so if I execute this, it gives the empty list. Why? Because it cleared all the elements present in the list. So these are the 13 built-in functions or methods present inside a list. Okay, so what are those 13 here? Append, extend, insert, remove, pop, slice, reverse, length, min and max, count, index, sort, clear. Okay, so this is all about built-in functions or methods present inside a list. Okay, so I hope you understood the topic. Those who are watching my channel for the first time, I request you to please subscribe my channel and please share my videos to your friends and well-wishers. Please support my channel in all possible ways. Thank you. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day.